models are just text generation machines. They generate text based on probability distributions, meaning of all possible words, each word has a certain probability of being chosen, and then it just samples from that probability distribution. So for example, if you have the phrase cat in the next word is perhaps 90%. There's a 90% probability of choosing hat, but then there's a 10% probability of choosing 1,000 other words. And so 90 times out of 100, it might choose hat, but 10 times out of 100, it'll choose any one of these other words that have a probability. Say, I mean, there's tons of other words that could be chosen, but say, just to make this simple, the only other words that could be chosen would be cat in the house. Let's say house had a 5% probability and in the bathtub had a 5% probability. Imagine there were only two other words, okay? And they each had a 5% probability. So 90 times out of 100, the model would say hat. 5 times out of 100, it would actually say house, cat in the house. And then 5 times out of 100, it would say cat in the bathtub. And so it's this probability distribution where it is sampling from this probability distribution where all the words that it could possibly say have a certain probability of being chosen. And then there, it just grabs from that. So it's not always going to choose the most likely word. It could choose a word with a very small probability, just based on the fact that sometimes small probability events occur. And so how this has to do with hallucinations, if you don't know, are when models literally make things up and they say them with confidence. There's a bunch of reasons why hallucinations happen. One of them is, of course, the fact that the models don't actually have at their core, if they're not like specifically linked up to a database or to the web, which is an augmentation of large language models, but at their foundation, large language models, again, are just text generation machines. They don't know what is fact and what is fiction. They're just outputting text. And so they might choose a word with a low probability just based on chance and then just kind of run with it. And so if they said like cat in the house, then they're going to say, okay, cat in the house. And then they're going to go down this cat in the house direction, even though we were really supposed to go down the cat in the hat direction. Because of that small probability, it chose cat in the house. It's going to run with that because it doesn't know that it's wrong. And if you get into areas where there's more ambiguity, so there are some kind of safeguards on this where they really heavily skew towards the most likely word. So it's very unlikely you wouldn't choose hat and then go down like a random tangent. But there are still cases where it would hallucinate, for example, where it doesn't really know what the next word is. And when it's making things up, it's kind of like, you know, the distribution of possible next words is like pretty even. And it's like, I don't really know where I'm going to go, so I'm just going to choose. But the model doesn't think I don't know where I'm going to go. It's just sampling. And so it just makes things up. It just samples a word, then it sticks with that. And then it samples from the word that it just chose. You know what it's kind of like? It's kind of like those poem things that we would play in school where each person would write a sentence or even just a word and then pass it to the next person and then pass it to the next person. It's kind of like that. It's like it's chosen a word and now it's like, all right, this is the path that I'm on. What's the next word? You know, and it like updates its probability distribution of next words based on the word that was chosen before. And if a kind of random and unlikely word is chosen, then it's just going to go with it. It's just going to like keep going from there. Kind of like those poems we did in school. You just kind of went with it. It's like improv. And again, it's not checking anything against facts. So it doesn't know. And so you really have to be careful about these models making things up because they do. Because they're just word generators. And so some ways to mitigate this are, again, with like searching the web and then sticking that info from the web into the brain to have it reference like recent data specifically, like into the prompt, right? Or to have it reference a database where it kind of like, given the prompt you give it, it searches the database and finds most likely what the prompt that you've given it is referring to in the database and then sticking that info in its in the prompt as well, and then running the model. And so it's really just like adding info to the model's brain and then to the working memory context to generate new outputs.